Hello and welcome to this Lumineth Realm Lords painting video. In this video, we're going to be showing how to paint the armour, the robes and the plumes of the great nation of Iliatha. Now the model we're going to be painting is a Venari Aurelan Warden. However, by following this guide, you can paint any other unit that's in the army. Now the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Corax White, which is perfect for the colours we're going to be applying in this video. Now the first area we're going to concentrate on is the armour. And the first colour we'll be using is Apothecary White. So I'm just going to give the pot a quick shake. With that done, and I'm going to pop it open. Now I'm going to be using a medium layer brush for this because it can hold a fair amount of the actual contrast, but it's got a nice point to it for accuracy. So I'm just going to dollop some onto my palette. This is more just so I don't overload the brush. Give it a couple of twists just to get a nice point to it. Then we're ready to start applying that to the armour. So all I'm going to do is just work on the helmet, the shoulder pauldrons and the breastplate. And don't forget the band braces. There we are with that contrast paint now dry. We're going to move on to doing some layering and highlighting. Now first of all, we're going to start with Corax White, which we'll use as a layer and just pick out some of those raised edges as more of a highlight. And after that, we'll move on to White Scar as a final highlight. But first of all, let's start with Corax White. So all I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to the palette like so. A little touch of water, a little bit more than that. I'm using a small layer brush for this as well, just for more accuracy. So get a nice point to the brush, spin it around. And then what we're going to start doing is start picking out those raised panels. So on the actual pauldron here, I'm just going to do the whole area, just leaving that Apothecary White in the recesses like so. So keep doing that. Again, with it being thinned, you'll get a nice smoother coverage. So work all your way around doing that. And the actual banding on the armour, I'm just going to run the edge of my brush around like so, just to add some more definition. So just keep picking out all those raised bits. The Corax White now layered over, we're now going to start highlighting using White Scar. So we're just going to go mainly around the banding here and just start picking out some of those areas. Again, just picking areas where you think the light would touch the most. Take your time. If you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with some of those previous colours. There we are with the white armour now done. We're going to move on to painting the orange robes. Now for this, we're going to start with a base coat of Jacara orange. Then we're going to coat over contrast paint, which will be Griffon orange. And then finish off with a highlight of Taulite ochre. So first of all, let's start with that Jacara orange. So I'm just going to get a couple of dollops onto the palette like so. A little touch of water. Get a nice point to my brush. Again, I'm using a medium layer brush for this because there's some large areas to paint. So it just means it gets it done a bit quicker. So all I'm going to do is just start coating that on the skirt like so. Now that we've base coated the robes with Jacara orange and just tidied up the trim with a little bit of Corax White, we're going to start applying Griffon orange to those robes. Just take your time, work it around and try and get some into those recesses as well. So just stab it a little bit, that'll help it settle a bit more. With that contrast now dry, we're going to move on to doing a highlight, and for this we're using Taulite ochre. So all I'm aiming to do is pick out those raised areas on the folds of the cloth. Just work your way around. If you're not sure where those are, just check the box art for details. With the orange robes now done, we're going to move on to painting the red details. So this is going to be like the inner robe, the sigil on his chest and also his plume. Now for this we'll be starting off with corn red, we'll then shade it with Norn oil, we're then going to highlight up using Evil Sun Scarlet, then finish off with Taulite ochre as a final highlight. So first of all, let's start with that base coat of corn red. So I'm going to apply a little bit to the palette, a little touch of water, get a nice point to my brush. I'm using a small layer one here as well because obviously we've got some little details to pick out. So I'm just going to start with the inner robe just here. So I'm just going to start base coating that. I might have to do a couple of coats because some of that Corax White will show through. We've got a little sigil here. We've got this design on his breastplate and of course the plume there as well. There we are with the red now base coated. I'm going to start using Norn oil. Now for the robes, we're just going to start running it into the recesses like so, just add a bit of definition. So that's nice and easy. You can tidy back up with a little bit of corn red if you need to. For the actual plume and all the other details, you can just apply that straight over, without worrying about just getting the recesses. Once the shade's dry, we're going to start highlighting with Evil Sun Scarlet. So on the robes, I'm just going to start picking out those raised bits like so. Do the same thing on the sigils and also on the plume as well. With the robes now highlighted with Evil Sun Scarlet, we're going to finish off by using Taulite ochre. I'm just going to concentrate this on the very tips just down here like so. So not too much at all. And then do the same with the plume as well. There we are with the Taulite ochre now highlighted. Our Venari Aurelan Warden of the great nation of Iliatha is now done. Now by following this guide for the armour, the robes and the plumes, you can paint any model in your collection in this particular colour scheme. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Lumineth Realm Lords and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.